And hello, everybody! I heard you missed us. We're back!
We're back.
I brought my pencil.
You're right.
Give me something to write on, man.
Give me something to write on. Nobody says hot for teacher in my classroom. No.
I don't feel tardy.
Yeah.
Welcome to episode lucky number 13. Mm-hmm. Should have been 14, but of course, you know, we took off last month, right?
Yep, we needed a little bit of a little vacation, I guess.
Absolutely.
Rejuvenate the soul, if you will.
Yes, exactly. And work through all the questioning of why we're actually doing this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Does that count as a midlife crisis for a podcast after our first year? Does that count?
It does. Yeah, exactly. That's when you step back and say, what the fuck am I doing?
Yeah, do I want to do this shit anymore?
Really? So we did take last month off, but we are back and we have got a banger today, mm-hmm. This is a very, very, very special episode we wanted to do for our welcome back. And we actually have guests today.
Mm-hmm. They're not here yet.
They're not. They're waiting in the wings, though. Mm-hmm. So if you've been watching or listening to the show, you know we don't do guests. We've had a number of people ask if they could be guests on the show. We don't do guests because 99% of guests are fucking boring.
I was going to say, because we're selfish pricks. That's why.
Well, that too. But most woodworking, most podcasts in general, guests are a way to come up with filler material because the hosts have run out of things to talk about. It's why you go on double dates when you've been married a long time because, new people to talk to.
Spice it up a little bit, or at least that's the goal.
Exactly. But Jered and I are still newlyweds, actually, in the podcast game. And speaking of newlyweds, that's a hint about what's coming up because the guests are, you want to tell them who it is?
They are our lovely wives. Da, 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 da.
Yes,
I don't know the damn theme song. I would have done it right there, but
that's the dating game. No. We're not giving away our wives in the dating game. No, that's not it. But we are playing the newlywed game with our wives today. So stay tuned for that. That's coming right up just in just a few minutes.
They may steal the show. They may.
Yeah. We'll see. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But first, viewer comments. These are from a couple of months ago. This was our Woodworking March Madness wrap-up episode, among other things. And we got a comment that said, I think I've said it before, but you guys are a real breath of cranky fresh air. Now that this thing is over, can I crawl back into my hole? And that was from at Wood Whisperer.
Yeah, we'll let you off the hook.
We will let you off the hook for at least another year there, Mark. Mm-hmm. So,
but keep those Oreo videos coming, Mark. Keep those Oreo videos coming. Love it.
Yeah. Thanks so much for the shout out and the really kind words. Great podcast as well. Thanks once again, lads. That's from Steve Bell Creates.
And
he was your video spotlight last episode. And I love when we spotlight their videos, they notice, right? Because we mention them in the description, but a lot of times they either don't see it or if they see it, they don't care. So it's nice. It's nice when they say thanks, right?
There's an actual human on the other end of that video.
Yeah, absolutely. The segment about Workbench Con and making connections with people hit the ball out of the park. This advice doesn't just hold for YouTube. It is universal. That's from Michael at MJL Woodworks. And that's true, right? You just can't, like I said in the last video, you can't really progress in an endeavor without, even if it's just for camaraderie or brotherhood or fellowship or whatever you want to call it, you know, just having people around to help, to bounce ideas off of, to just know what you're going through, right?
Yeah. Yeah. To be a soundboard, test some ideas.
Sure.
Have somebody that'll give you an honest opinion and tell you something sucks. I mean, it's definitely valued.
Right. Yep, it sure is. And one more. Maybe I'm alone in this, but I can't support channels that sell out cheaply. As creators, ask yourselves if there isn't a better way. Because people I do watch have even got non-craft related sponsors, so you don't have to sell out to make it happen. That's from Corey Shockey. And that's a really good point. I guess there are, in the woodworking genre, among sponsored videos, there are really two kinds, right? So there are ones who are basically just tool shills. Mm-hmm. And there are sponsored videos where the product or service being advertised really has nothing to do with woodworking. Mm-hmm. You know, I talked to John Cesaro, and those are the only ones he does now. He does not really do any woodworking related sponsorships. And that probably is pretty smart, because it doesn't behold you to one brand against another brand. It doesn't alienate other people in your field. You know, if you do a read for Jackery Batteries or Policy Genius or something, you know, you're not gonna make, you know, Milwaukee mad or DeWalt mad or Jessam mad or this person mad or that.
Yeah, you know, and the more of those kind of niche specific type sponsors, then you get branded a shill or whatever, and you may alienate your audience. But, you know, yeah, when you're doing stuff that's not really completely related to woodworking, yeah, it's whatever. You just kind of take it for what it is, and you go, all right, good for that guy. He got a sponsorship. Cool. Maybe it randomly is a thing that I was thinking about looking into, and cool, you just move on.
Right. Yeah. So Jered did a pretty cool thing, actually, after we did the Woodworking March Madness. He made some trophies, and I want you to show the audience the trophies you made. Can you pull them up on your phone?
Oh, no. I think it deleted the photos.
What?
Yeah. Oh, hang on a second. Oh, shit. Okay. Yeah, I got them. I posted something to Instagram for once, so I do have some evidence that I actually did this. Now, hopefully you'll be able to see this without the glare. So there's the Wood Whisperer one, and it's walnut. And full disclosure, this one I did not like, so I threw this one away and I redid it. But the Jonathan Katz Moses one, there it is. Hopefully there's a little closer.
You really, you did the real logos and everything. Yeah.
I did fantastic. The logos and everything. I didn't take pictures of the backside, but I asked Lee to sign his life away so that I could steal his identity in secret. And I used a shameless plug, the old Shaper Trace here. And I put a silly little thing on the backside and engraved our signatures in it and everything. So I just figured, you know, hey, they didn't have to get involved. They didn't have to play along. They could have easily just sloughed it off as a couple of jabronis that are just trying to get a little attention here. But, you know, they actually played along. We went through the whole thing last episode, but I thought it was just a nice gesture to send something off. And Mark was really nice to do a Instagram story and put it next to the big mallet hammer thing that he's got. And I shit you not, I jumped for joy. So that was like a validating moment. But yeah, it was just a nice little thing. I had some scrap lumber lying around, decided it'd be a little fun, and sent it off to him a few weeks ago.
So you did what? So you did the grand champion trophy was in walnut, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And then the first iteration was in
maple. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, that cool. Not that walnut is any much better than maple. It's just what I had lying around, and you know, they turned out pretty cool. I liked them.
Yeah. So we did miss the last episode, and so during that episode, we talked about that we were going to hold a contest, and we did for whoever would donate to the Katz Moses Woodworkers with Disabilities Fund and send us a receipt would be entered into a chance to win a $100 gift certificate from Katz Moses Tool Store. We did not get a chance to draw it live because we didn't do the last episode, but I do want to tell you who the winner was because I didn't want them to have to wait. It is Edward Thomas. And Edward Thomas is already aware that he won.
Hey.
Right, Edward, your gift certificate should be coming in your email soon, as long as Jonathan remembers that he promised to do this. I don't know. Maybe he's forgotten by now.
Oh, geez.
Yeah. So, hey, and there's one other thing before we get into the reason we're all here, to introduce our lovely wives and have them play the Newlywed game with us. I did a thing. I started a Patreon, patreon.com/bustedknucklewoodworks. I'll put a link to it in the description here, and I'll put a thing down here in the bottom. But it's been kind of interesting and fun, and I think what I'd like to do is, starting next month, I think I'd like to create one for the show too. And Jered will be 100% responsible for that. So,
and delegate. Yeah.
Right.
So I'm taking the reins on this one. We'll see how it goes.
Exactly. Yeah. I'm not doing it for the podcast unless I can delegate, because I'm already doing enough for this thing. But yeah, that will be fantastic. In fact, funny story. I actually did go through the process of setting up a Patreon account for the new Cranky Workshop. But if you're familiar with Patreon, they have an option. They're trying to compete with OnlyFans. So they have an option where there's a particular box you can click while you're setting up the account that says, this is adult material. Hence, OnlyFans type material.
Okay.
And I did that.
Oh, goodness.
So there's a lot of things. There's a lot of things you can't. I discovered you. Yeah. That you cannot do if you have an adult account on Patreon. Number one, you can't offer a free tier. Yeah. I mean, there's like a lot of restrictions. So I'm like, oh my God. So the thing is, you can't just go and uncheck that box, because the thing is, once you've set up an account as an adult account, they don't just let you adult it, so to speak, because that would just now open up all kinds of pornography to the entire world.
What have you
world,
gotten me into kids, here, right? Lee? Jesus Christ. I'm a teacher, for Christ's sake. I got a little bit of a reputation to protect.
So long story short, I set up a fake OnlyFans account for Jered.
Oh.
Yeah, and that was not going to work, apparently. So I had to write to their support and say, hey, I did this by mistake. And they said, well, let us look at the content you've posted. And they looked at it and they said that they saw there was nothing posted at all. So they said, no problem. We'll just take it back. Yes. So they did. So now, so now we're ready to go. And I will give Jered the keys to that, and you can run with it, my friend.
All right.
So anyway,
no promises, but
are we ready to go?
Let's do it.
Are we ready to bring in the lovely ladies? Absolutely. And here we go. Oh, that's the dating game again. Come on out. Playing for the Dumont team, it's Tami. Hello.
Hello, everyone.
And
playing for Team Inland Wooden Resin / Team Wilson, my lovely wife, Amy.
Oh, fantastic.
There we go.
Wow, here they are. The you know what? The class of this show just went up like 3,000%.
And it, yeah, definitely easier on the eyes.
Yes, absolutely. So for those of you who don't know our wives, which is everybody, because they've never been on the show before. Now, my wife has been on my channel. She's been in a few videos of mine. And she steals the spotlight in every one. So we're going
to... I do what I can do. I do what I can do.
Why don't you go ahead and introduce yourself to the lovely people.
Hello, I'm Tami Dumond, a.k.a. Mrs. Busted Knuckle Woodworks. And when I'm not busting his knuckles, I am a food quality manager.
Food quality manager?
Yes.
Right. Okay. So you know what that means, right? the E. coli, the salmonella, the listeria, the methicillin resistant staph aureus.
He's 3 second rule is followed here. 0 seconds for me, but 3 seconds is allowed for him.
Right. Exactly. And
I am Amy Wilson, Mrs. Inland Wood and Resin, I guess. And when I'm not here, I am a high school science teacher. So, yeah.
High school science teacher.
Nice. Yeah. Nice. We need our own podcast, Amy. That's what we need.
I think the science thing is.
They could be a guest on ours. Yeah.
Yeah. You can call it the new Icky Workshop if you have a podcast. Yeah. With all the germs and the science. Absolutely. How come you guys are sitting at such like a, what's this deal?
She's got the nice stool that I made for my craft shows, and I'm sitting on my busted ass rolly chair that doesn't lift up anymore.
Right. Isn't that weird, right? Because I'm sitting on a garage sale find and she's sitting on my $1,000 Viper. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You get the better seat.
We're making do.
And I get making to be taller than you, which is never the case.
Exactly. I just thought you had a supermodel.
Yeah, exactly.
She's That's what I was thinking. Too. Yeah, there it is.
Wish.
She's 6'7". She missed the WNBA draft, though, last night, so whatever.
For the benefit of people who do not remember how this show works, the Newlywed game, or if you're under 50, and don't remember the show. What happens is they will ask us questions. We'll ask them questions. One of us will write an answer down, and the other one has to guess what the other person wrote. And if you guess, you get 10 points. And one 25-point question. They always did the 25-point question at the end because that would swing a lot of leads. Let's get going. I'm going to ask the first question, and I'm going to ask it to Amy. Amy will write down her answer, and then later, Jered will have to guess that answer. The question is, when was the last time Jered had to call in a pro to repair or improve something in your home?
Oh.
It has to be woodworking or...
Nope, just to improve or repair something in your home. Any kind of professional where Jered had to admit defeat because he could not do it himself.
Okay.
All right.
I'm going to say this is
professionalism doesn't equal weakness. I just want to say that. So.
All right, Jered, go ahead and ask Tami a question.
Okay, Tami, on a scale of 1 to 5, with 1 being low, 5 being high, how much say do you have when it comes to Lee buying tools, supplies, or wood for any of your projects? I feel like I need to...
Yeah. Like a boomerang.
We got that one down.
Okay. Amy, go ahead and ask me a question, and I will write down the answer.
All right, Lee. What is the one project Tami wants you to do, but you haven't done yet?
This is going to be hard because there's like 15.
Uh-huh. This is easy.
Oh.
That's
so
what we
think,
right?
Okay, so that's a good question, though.
All right, Jered, are you ready?
I got this.
When was the last time Jered took you out for a meal that cost over $100? Wow.
That's the qualifier.
He's trying to get you in trouble. This is what's going on. Yeah.
That wasn't $100, but that one pissed me off big time.
No kibitzing over there.
We took that back in. I'm thinking you have to go back to California.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a... Oof.
Come on, you cheapskate. You can't remember.
It's only the two of us. That's what it is. I say, I can't even eat that much to hit $100.
Yeah, but if you go to a fancy place, you can run up a $100 bill easy.
Lee, when was the last time you think he took me to a fancy place?
I think he's opening up a can of worms here too, because I can't even answer this one.
I'm really struggling with this one. You guys might need to like go on without me. This could take 20 to 30 minutes. That's such a bad response. There we go. I think I got something.
All right.
I'm admitting defeat on that question. All right, Tami, you ready?
Yes.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how good of a woodworker does Lee think he is?
Son of a bitch! What? Scale of 1 to 10.
I'm trying to think of good self-esteem days and bad self-esteem days, and then try to make an average of that. That's my
very scientific. Very scientific.
Okay, I got that.
Okay, it's my turn to ask a question of Amy. Right? What is the number one thing Jered needs to fix in your house right now?
That's a good question.
There must be something broken.
I'm trying to think. There's not a whole lot broken.
I can come over and break some things.
There's definitely additions, but not anything that I can think of. That. Well, yes, there is. Yes, there is.
I know.
There's always something.
I won't coach you up on this one, but yes, there is.
All right. Have you got your answer?
Yes.
Good.
Jotted.
I think it's
me.
Yep.
I think it's me.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, Lee. If Tami were a woodworking tool, what tool would she be?
Ooh, if she were a woodworking tool, what tool would she be?
Something like that.
Yeah. Is there anything that goes like this?
A broken router.
No, I'm going to say...
Depending on how fast you pull.
If she were a woodworking tool, what tool would she be? I'm going to say... Okay.
It's like, don't say it out loud.
I got it.
I know, I was waiting.
All right.
I would be a kind of tool that you would lose the accessories. Just gonna admit that right now.
That's a running joke in our house, right? Because if she ever buys anything that has like parts or accessories or any kind of extra thing that goes, it's not attached, those evaporate within 5 minutes.
Yeah, it must be things that can be attached to the main thing. If not,
right,
it's a goner.
It's gone. It's a goner. Yeah, right. Whenever something comes in from Amazon, I'm like, I hope there's no accessories with that.
Yeah. How many pieces does this thing have?
One piece.
Yeah.
No matter how many. Just one.
Just one.
Now it is your turn to ask Jered one more question.
Okay. Jered, what is the number one woodworking DIY or home maintenance project that Jered has already started that you wish he would finish?
I am notorious for starting things and actually finishing them.
He is.
Wow, really?
My dad, on the other hand, is not.
Mine either.
Or maybe a project that you wanted to start, but you maybe
haven't. Now, that's the essential question. Which project do I want to start for Amy?
For anything.
Okay.
For anything.
Can be around your house or whatever. It doesn't have to be something like a gift.
Okay. There's three.
That one project you've said out loud that you're like, man, we should do this, or, you know, and
Okay.
We just haven't ever started it. Never bought the wood for it. Never no plans yet. But, you know,
never
just talked
started.
About it.
Started. Well, that yeah. started. So that's just never going to get finished. So that one's off the table. So
well, that's I've there you go. That's started. Your
now
answer.
Now I've whittled it down to two.
Okay.
I'm going to say that. That's the easier of the two. Okay. I got it. I got an okay. answer.
You got an answer?
Second one was a lot easier than the first one. I'm still trying to think of when I did that.
So are we all done? Are we? Yep. Have we gone through all the questions?
We got
okay.
it.
Great. So let's go back through. And we will find the answers. The first question was, when was the last time Jered had to call in a pro to repair or improve something in your home? Amy said.
Well, I know what that, I know what the answer is here.
Okay.
I know this.
Sorry.
The last time I called in a pro was a plumbing clog to the tune of $400 and something for literally 10 minutes worth of work. Because that one's hair and my daughter's hair clogged the drain. And I'm sure, yeah, there's probably a little bit of this. But none of this. This gets trimmed in the shop. That was the last time.
And Amy said, plumber clog.
Yay!
Dang. Okay,
and right
that's
after
10
that,
points for the Wilsons.
Right after that, I went down to Home Depot and I bought a $70 Ryobi auger. It'll never be a $400 fix again.
There you go. Now it's going to be a $70 fix. Yeah.
I'm already going to predict that they're going to win. I'm just going to predict that
oh
right
my
now.
Gosh.
I'm going to go bet on it really quick.
Come on. All right.
Okay. I think I asked the second question. So this one was to Tami on a scale of 1 to 5. How much say do you have when it comes to Lee buying tools, supplies, or wood for any of your projects?
Yeah, this is the easiest question in history because I wear the pants in my family. So the answer is zero.
Okay, he wears a cargo pants in the family.
Hey,
and that's as far
that.
As that goes.
That's where we lose all our parts and pieces.
And so what was your number?
Zero.
Oh, so close because I put 0.1.
Oh, come on.
You were so close. Because sometimes I have to help him. He will buy something that I have to help pull out of the truck. So he
okay,
got
I'm
a point one on
I'm
that.
I'm counting that.
That counts.
I hope you build a drawer for those big pants.
This is not going to end well.
All right. The next question was, when was the last time Jered took you out for a meal that cost over $100?
I don't blame you guys. This is a tough one.
This is.
Jered had a hankering for a particular kind of food. So I, being the lovely wife, said, okay, let's go through the drive-thru, right? So Jered orders what he wants to order. We get to the window. And it is $75.
It's close.
For Kentucky Fried Chicken. And that's
what I was. What? KFC was damn near $100 for three people? Oh, my God.
I was so pissed.
Did you get the non-GMO chicken?
How did that happen?
I don't know.
Everything was
how?
Organic. Handmade.
I don't know.
Hand-plucked.
Apparently, I'm out of fast food ordering practice because I used to be really good at it. And I just ordered what I wanted, and it was $75. So I was so pissed.
His first mistake was he ordered the family meal. We
There's
don't have
mistake.
Like six people. So if we had done like individual, you get this, you get that, it probably wouldn't have been more than like $30. But yeah.
There's three people in your family, right? Did you order three family meals? Is that what happened?
One family meal, an extra meal okay. for the baby. Look, she didn't want chicken.
I really like their damn mashed potatoes and those damn biscuits. I really do.
Oh yeah, well you got your money's worth on the mashed potatoes and the biscuits.
For 75 lunch for bucks. 2 days afterwards, so I did get my money's worth.
Yeah, okay.
Look, Jered, me and you will get along fine. My eyes, you know, order for me mm-hmm. a lot, which I can't back up. You know, I try. Told you they're going to win. Knew it.
Okay. So the question was, excuse me, on a scale of 1 to 10, how good of a woodworker does Lee think he is?
I'm going to say that she said, it's how good of a woodworker do I think I...
Yes.
This is complicated because it's how good of a woodworker do I think that she thinks that I think that I am.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, let me answer this in two parts. I think I'm a 7. I think that she thinks I'm an 8.
The chuckle. I like
that. Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Okay. Not by the amount of cussing and going trips to Home Depot. Oh. I think...
Oh.
I said 5.
You said 5.
Because you, it was worded just like a voting.
Listen. Give me this.
Listen to me. This is the truth. Because, listen, you asked what he thought of himself.
Mm-hmm.
You thought what him thought of himself. And most days he considers himself a 1. Okay. I'm just going to tell you. He's yelling at himself. He's like, he's so mad at everything. Mm-hmm. He's had to go to Home Depot 3 times and then he ordered something and it was the wrong thing. He always puts himself down, but I think that's what makes him strive to be a better, thing. Now, what I think of him, I do think that he, as if you ask my opinion, I do think he's an 8, not giving him a 10. You know, he hasn't carved me a tiki pole, out in the backyard from the thing yet, but. And some other items that I've requested. So we're not going to give him a 10, but I give him an 8 of what I think that he is. But I think that he thinks he's a 5, that he's just an average Joe who wants to make things and is always striving to learn more. So that's why I set a 5, honey.
Yeah, that's a good answer. That's a good answer because I didn't really think of that. I guess I don't know how it comes off, right? Because when I'm in the shop, sometimes I'm always like, God, I suck at this so hard. Yep. And I'm coming back into the house and I'm like, she's like, what's wrong? I go, I can't do this. What am I doing?
Yeah.
So then I have
Why
to sing
I
a song
subjecting
going,
myself
you're the
shit.
Best woodworker ever.
You need Tami to you're do your so jingles. Great.
You're so fantastic. Look at that wood. Look at that square. Ooh, there's a nail. I do my wife part.
There it
do
is.
My wife part.
There it is. So. That's in the trailer, boys and girls. There it is.
Okay. It's so sturdy. I'd say that a lot.
All right, we don't need to get into our business, so to speak. Okay.
Business.
All right.
It's going off the rails. Here we go.
It's funny.
Okay. What is the number one thing Jered needs to fix in your house right now?
My mouth.
I'm going to say it is the front screen door.
And you said, front screen door!
It's YouTube the video.
First thing you
shortly.
Look at when you come into the house to remind you.
That goddamn thing.
Hold on a second. So that was a 25-point question. That is a perfect score for the Wilsons. 25, 35, 45 points. We've already mathematically lost, but go ahead, ask us our last question.
There's still one question left.
All right.
Still got somewhat of a chance.
Lee, if Tami were a woodworking tool, what tool would she be?
You can't write it down.
I thought I was supposed to answer it.
No. Oh, my okay. God, Tami.
Okay.
We're at the answering round now. Okay. So you say what you think I wrote down.
Okay.
All right. Go ahead.
Look. You're the one that's going back and forth with the questions.
I know. It's hard. Keep track.
Would you choose me if this was the dating show?
Of course I would.
She's cute. She's just a little ditzy.
just the way I like him.
She sounds good.
Okay. So if you were a woodworking tool, what tool would I say that you were? Is that the question? Yeah.
Yes. Okay. Are you ready?
Yeah, go ahead.
I'm going to say a saw because I cut everything in half. He says that if this food company that I was helping, I'm the one that made the Twix. I'm the one that made it.
She likes to break things up, you know. So I always say, you know, left Twix and right Twix. That was because Tami went to work for them.
I like a good, you know, a good polarization there. So.
Yeah. I said table saw.
There it is. Ding, ding, ding.
Oh, that's good.
That's
okay.
Kevin, that's
ding,
good. Ding, we ding. Got one.
We got two. Yeah. Mm-hmm. We got the first one and
So you gave me the 0.1.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay. So I got 30. Oh, that's good.
So the final score is the Dumonts 35 and the Wilsons 45. Let's give them a hand.
Good job. Clearly you're gonna stay married. Clearly.
Yes. Yeah. You are better than us. You're
We're in
a better
trouble.
Couple.
We're going to have to go to counseling.
We suck compared to them. They're great. And I don't know. Why don't we just.
Well, I think we'd like.
You know, we had a good run. Okay.
See, we've learned to not know each other well.
Yeah.
There you go. Silver lining.
There you go.
Yeah. Let's just bag it. I mean, come on.
Oh,
I
mean, you mean really, bag it? Yeah. Okay. Hey, Jered, you guys got a room?
We do. We have a guest room. Uh-huh. Yeah. It's a nice bed too.
Uh-huh.
Cool. It's comfy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Lots All right. We have a guest room door. And I made the bed.
I know. Hey.
You can sleep in there for a couple
it's
days.
It's very sturdy.
And circle around. There it is.
Yay. Fantastic. Thank you very much. Pleasure. Thank you. And thank you. I'm shaking hands with Amy there. Yeah, fantastic. And, you know, one thing we didn't do on the real show, whenever they got a right answer, they would always give a little peck like this, right?
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And then whenever they didn't, they'd always tell the woman to roll her eyes and put the card in the slot. Like,
I should have done that because that's what I do normally.
I know. Yeah, you're so good at it. She is so good at it. Well, hey, it's been lovely having you lovely ladies on, and we've got to get on with the rest of the show.
Yeah, go do some woodworking stuff. Yeah,
okay.
All right.
But we should do this again.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. We should.
We should.
We should. So that way we can lose again. We need another try at losing. I always said that if we did the world's race, you know, that one is
oh,
well,
amazing race.
We would have never made it out of the parking lot. Never made it out of the parking lot. We would have argued of which car to take.
Yeah. We would have went
direction.
We would have went in two different directions.
And we would have broke up right there. We would have done it.
Yeah. You don't know where we're going.
It's a running joke. We just do this though, but it is fun. Is that every time we go to a hotel, we get two keys. We get two keys in case we break up. So that somebody else can get in. You just can't like lock them out.
We get two keys in case one of us loses it.
Yeah, there you go.
All right.
Beautiful.
All right.
Love
well,
it.
Thanks, guys. It was nice meeting you.
It was lovely. Wow.
Yes. All right.
Yeah.
Have fun at school. Great. I love teaching too as well. I used to be a substitute teacher and I love teaching. So he knows that... I've got a thing for teachers. So thank you so much for your service.
Thank you.
I appreciate it.
Okay. It's fun. She didn't go to war or anything.
Yeah, she did.
Well, yeah, probably. Yeah,
she
actually.
Every day.
She's a high school teacher. So I
don't think
I forget.
I don't think any soldier would be able to handle a high school.
Yeah. Seriously.
Yeah. Thank you.
There they are.
Yeah. Our better halves. Where would we be without them?
Probably on a beanbag, eating Cheetos, watching baseball all night. That's what I
do. Oh, my God. Dude, when my wife met me, I was living like a coyote. Okay, I had one fork, one spoon, one knife, one plate.
Yeah.
It was fucking horrendous. All right. She saved my life. She saved my life more than once. So,
yeah.
And now it's time for, we are not doing, by the way, if you've been waiting for it, what's making me cranky right now. But I will say what's making me cranky right now is I did not get an afternoon nap and it's very hot in here. So that's, those are the two things that are making me cranky right now.
Yeah. I know that feeling. I know.
So let's get into video spotlights. Video spotlights.
Okay. I'm up first, right? This time around. All right. Yes, so you are, sir. The video that I'm going to be spotlighting, the name of the video is So I Guess I Built My Dream Workbench. And it is by, and I hope I don't butcher this, Gillis Bjork.
I think that's right.
I'm sticking with my international flair. And about, I guess a month and a half ago or so, I went down the rabbit hole of watching workbench videos because I had a project that I had in mind and I needed inspiration. And of course, when you do a workbench video search, you get boring stuff, quite frankly. And then you get the overly complicated, decorative, beautiful, ornate furniture pieces. And neither of those were what I was looking for. I eventually found inspiration in a few videos, but towards the end of my search, I stumbled across this video and it is fantastic. It's 25, 30 minutes long. It is a step-by-step of how he goes about looking at his old bench saying, this is no longer working for me and I need to do this. And I'm not going to rush out and buy all brand new material. I am going to rummage through my scrap and figure out what I can salvage and use and incorporate into the video or into the build. And I think he jokingly at one point says he uses an entire forest in this build. I mean, there's pine, there's fir, there is oak, there's beech, there's like 10 different species. And he just goes, I got this piece and I need this part and cobbles it all together. And it is absolutely amazing what he comes up with. I mean, it's a traditional kind of English / Rubo hybrid type woodworking bench, but it's gorgeous. And, you know, it's got a very kind of dry narrative to it and he walks you through the steps, but it's not boring. He's got some very dry humor in there. So as you're watching, he'll throw a little joke in or two and it's a good view. It's a good watch. I really enjoyed it. Again, the name of the video is So I Guess I Built My Dream Workbench by Gillis Bjork.
Yeah, I liked this video. It was kind of an interesting hybrid approach between mostly hand tools, except mm-hmm. I think he used an electric plane, electric mm-hmm. drill at some point. I think he used a circular saw a couple of times, but then he used a handsaw a lot. And I found it a little odd, right? Because it's like, well, you have a circular saw. No one's going to be able to tell. Why are you sawing through this 4x4 with my
hand? Yeah. You know, like you said, he uses that hand plane and he flat out says it. I think he does it two or three times in the video where he's just like, it's faster. Like yeah, there's, exactly. You know, why am I going to sit there and push a scrub plane through when I can just do this thing? And
Well, right. But why does he cut through a 4x4 with a handsaw though?
You maybe know, it was just Western his inch. Shoulder was feeling it too much from all the chiseling and hammer work or mallet work. I don't know. Whatever.
I don't know.
Great video though.
But, very good. But yeah, he hand cut all the mortises and the tenons and hand cut like the dovetails. Mm-hmm. It was great. And he even basically made his own tail vise, which was cool too. Yeah. I mean, it's so easy to just go and buy a store bought tail vise and be done. Right. But it was great. Yeah. So mine is, table saw plus miter saw workbench like no other. And it is from a channel called Van Isle Studio. And this is actually not an American channel. But he's in Vancouver. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, doesn't that count as America, really?
It's America's attic. We almost stole it from the British, I guess. Almost.
Exactly. It should be ours. Right. So, and the reason I'm recommending this is, first of all, it's very, very entertaining. He does a lot of really great, the edit is really cool. The motion graphics are cool. The reason I'm posting it is because I think this is a perfect illustration, the YouTube secret behind why some build channels succeed and most do not. The only way you can get big views on a build video is if you can manage to make a show that is entertaining and engaging and compelling enough to interest somebody that isn't interested in the specific topic. Mm-hmm. If you can do that, that's a bingo. I mean, when you see Cam Anderson from Blacktail Studio build an epoxy table and get 5 million views, do you think it's because there are 5 million people who searched this, who searched epoxy table on the internet?
No.
To build an epoxy? No. No. People who have no interest in ever building an epoxy table, or people who have no interest in ever building any mid-century furniture, are watching Chris from Four Eyes Furniture because those are entertaining, compelling, interesting, engaging videos in and of themselves. Mm-hmm. It's an outfeed table for a job site saw that he modifies to put a flip-top miter station in it. And the design is completely ingenious. Mm-hmm. If you watch it till the end, you'll be blown away. I have no interest in building something like that, but I watched the whole video because he realizes, he gets it. You're not building a flip-top miter station. You're making a TV show about building a flip-top miter station. And you see, there's a subtle difference, right? Mm-hmm. He uses some really clever editing techniques to mark the passage of a lot of time by using fast cuts. He times them to the music. He uses some really interesting split screen point of view techniques. And these aren't hard things to do, right? They just take time and a little imagination. Mm-hmm. And, you know, the whole video isn't perfect. There are some parts where the music was a little loud, and there was the little motion graphic he did with the robot. Kind of seemed non sequitur, but yeah, it's crazy good, this video. So
yeah,
that is it. Table saw plus miter saw plus workbench like no other Van Isle studio. Go ahead, Jared.
So when you posted that this was going to be your recommendation, I went, oh, shit. Because I watched his original outfeed table build, which I think right now has got like over 500,000 views. And It's not because it's this ultra entertaining build. It's because it's an entertaining video. And when I saw that it was the same channel, I went, oh shit. Cause I'm in the middle of doing a workbench video. It's totally different. It has a completely different narrative. And I like in the back of my mind, as I'm watching this video, I'm going, God damn it. This thing is just going to absolutely blow my video out of the fucking water. I don't remember the time in between posting of those two videos, but I mean, to put together a video of that caliber and quality is not something you do in a weekend. That is a day's worth of not only the actual build, but then weeks probably.
Oh yeah.
Of being in post and dialing that video in. And it is absolutely top notch.
I wouldn't be surprised if that was easily 100 hours just in post-production.
I guess my only criticism of that video is the thumbnails. Like it's got this odd little joint that makes sense once you watch the video. But I think from us as onlookers, as creators, we look at it and we go, that thumbnail doesn't really fit the video, but it makes sense when you watch the video. But other than that, I mean, God, it is a phenomenal 25 minutes as far as just the engagement value of it. It is fantastic.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, he's only got 6 videos. He's a pretty new channel. I don't know if he's collaborating with anyone or really if he's made any kind of connections in the field or in the industry, But Paul, if you want to reach out to me or Jered or both, we'd love to talk to you. I would love to talk to you.
Yeah.
Like offline, like not on the show, but, yeah, because first of all, I think really you could benefit from some feedback. And, I think you're like 95% of the way there though, man. Yeah.
You get it. He's not going to be a channel that's, he's not a channel that's going to be cranking them out, you know, once a month or once or twice a month or something like that. You're going to get his best effort every single time out. And it's an interesting channel to take note of and to give a subscribe to, because you're going to get really good stuff from that channel.
Yeah. All right. Well, that does it for episode 13, lucky number 13. Let's thank the wives again.
Yay.
I don't know. She's long gone. Long gone. Yeah. Okay. And thanks for listening, everybody. It's hot.
Spring has sprung.
Hold on. Mr. Cool going in soon. Look for that video. There will be a Mr. Cool video on Busted Knuckle Woodworks. I'm going to be hanging meat in here next podcast, okay? So. All right. Adios.
Okay. All right, buddy.
Au revoir. Au revoir.
As they say. Au revoir.
Au revoir.